Good morning, all of you. This is a continuation class for immunodiffusion techniques. So we already discussed about various qualitative and quantitative immunodiffusion techniques, and also radioimmunoassay, that is a immunochemical quantitative assay. And here in today's class, we will discuss about the another immuno chemical assays or the immunoassay and quantitative analytical procedure, which is generally used in various laboratories. So ELISA, also called as the full name for ELISA is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. So ELISA was introduced by the Peter Perlman and Eva Engvall in 1971 at Stockholm University in Sweden. And the general principle for ELISA, the enzyme linked immunoassay, are: it is a plate based quantitative immunoassay using enzymes such as horse radish peroxidase and alkaline phosphatase, which is linked to the antigen or antibody molecule. And presence of the enzyme linked antigen and antibody molecule, which is detected by the means of an enzyme substrate to generate a color product, and can be measured by spectrophotometry. This is the principle. So here nothing but here the ELISA, here we are using enzymes which is labeled to the antigen or antibody. So these will bind with the specific antigen or antibody which we wanted to detect. So after these labeled antigens will bind with the antigen or antibody or antibodies, so their presence, that is antigen antibody, that is the immune reaction which is detected by using enzymes by adding the substrate. So this substrate which is added after act upon by the enzymes which are already present, and will give the color products which will be quantified by using spectrophotometry. And general procedure and requirement for ELISA are: here the micro tetraplate which contain 96 polystyrene wells, which is coated with either antigen or antibody, and reagents needed for the testing like sample dilutants and also controls, which is positive and negative controls to standardize the assay, and wash concentrate to wash unbound material from the plate, and conjugates like enzyme labeled antibodies and substrate which act upon by the enzymes based on the enzyme we taken, and stop solution to stop the substrate reaction and color development, and also glass beakers, micro tetraplates and tips, micropipettes, and ELISA washer and ELISA reader. These are the general requirements for the ELISA. Here you can see the instrument, washer, and also reader, also same look like, and micropipettes and micro tetraplates and reagents, so enzymes, conjugates and wash buffers, all are there. Okay, so this is a micro tetraplate containing 96 micro tetra wells. Initially we will add the positive and negative control and standards, different standard, so based on the presence or absent or concentration of the analyte or antigen or antibody which is from the sample. So the color will be developed, which is quantified by using spectrophotometer. And the general procedure for ELISA here: first one is coating, that is polystyrene plates, that is the micro tetra wells, which is treated with a solution of either antigen or antibody along with the controls, and after incubation remove liquid and wash the plate with the wash buffers and blocking. Next, an unrelated protein based solution is used to cover all unbound sites on the plates, and we have to remove liquid and wash the plates. and also detection. So enzyme conjugated antigen or antibody binds specifically to the target antigen or antibody. Then we have to remove the liquid and wash the plate, and substrate is added and enzyme substrate reaction and the color developed which is produced, and the stop the reaction with the stop reagent and read the results in ELISA reader. Here you can see the microtiter plates which is coated with the anti T4 antibody for detection of T4 antigen. So hormone which is the antigen here, after adding which will bind specifically with the antibody which is present in the microtiter wells. To detect this one, we will add the antibody which is linked with the enzyme, that's why enzyme linked, and this will bind with the another site present on the hormone, and so this antigen antibody complex will be detected by adding the substrate. The substrate will acted upon by the enzyme which will give the reaction to give color. So this color development which will be quantified by using spectrophotometry. And there are different types, are broadly this ELISA classified into direct ELISA which is detect for the antigen, and indirect ELISA for antibodies detection, and sandwich ELISA for antigen detection, and competitive ELISA for antigen. Here you can see the direct ELISA. The antigen is immobilized to the surface of the microtiter plates first and detected with the antibody which is specific for that antigen and which is directly conjugated to the enzyme, then act on the substrate to give the color. In the previous example we told about, we added for antigen detection we added antibody coated plates, but here directly antigen is bind with the microtiter wells, not to the antibody. So here one antigen, one antibody is there, one enzyme labeled antibody is there. So this one to detect the antigen, that's why is a direct ELISA. And here in the antigen indirect ELISA for antibodies, first the microtiter plates are coated with the specific antigen which is against the antibody. Here the microtiter plates are coated with the antigen, not the antibody. So here we want to detect the antibody, so the sample which contain the antibodies after adding into the microtiter plates will bind with the antigen present on the microtiter plates. So antigen antibody complex is formed. Then in order to detect this antigen antibody complex, again we will add the enzyme labeled antibody which is a goat anti-human immunoglobulin which is conjugated with the enzyme and added which bind with the antibody which is already present. Next a substrate is added to detect the binding, and in a positive reaction the enzyme acts on the substrate to produce the color. So this is a indirect ELISA for detection of antibodies. Here the same thing, next sandwich ELISA for antigen. So this method to detect the antigen is very sensitive, and the walls of the microtiter plates are coated with the specific antibody which is against the antigen to be detected. Next the specimen such as serum to be tested are added to the coated wells. If the antigen is present in the serum, that is a specific antigen which is present in the serum, it will combine with the coated antibody. Here you can see the specificity of the ELISA which is attributed or which is given by this. Even though the serum contain different antigens, only the specific antigen can bind with the specific antibody. So even though other antigens are present in the sample which cannot bind with that antibody in the microtiter plates, that's why. So these are the specific and sensitive technique. and the antibody conjugated with the enzyme is added to detect the antigen and antibody reaction. So the conjugated antibody combined with the antibody that has combined with antigen. Next, a substrate is added to the detection the binding of conjugated antibody to antigen antibody complex. In a positive test, the positive reaction is tested by change of color, which can be read by spectrophotometry or the ELISA readers. Here you can see, in order to detect the antigen, the microtetraplates are coated with the antibody, so which will capture or specifically bind with the antigen. To increase the sensitivity, we added another antibody which will bind with the another site on the antigen. Then we added extra enzyme linked antibody. If the antigen present in the sample, there means, so there is a this sandwich will be occurred. So antigen which is sandwiched between the both capture antibody and anti-human antibody, anti-human immunoglobulin, which is developed in the goat, so which will binded. In that only this enzyme linked antibody will bind, that will be give positive color. This is the same thing. Here antibody coated with the plates, and next add the patient serum which is contain the antigen, like example T4. Next add antibody. Here anti T4 antibodies raised in the rabbit. Here next they add HRP, horse radix peroxidase enzyme, which is conjugated with the second antibody. So anti rabbit IgG raised in the goat. Next, in the positive reaction, after adding the substrate, there is a development of color, and which will be read in the colorimeter or spectrophotometer. So the intensity of color directly proportional to the antigen concentration present in the sample. So if you see these images and you have to remember by picture, then you can write the principle easily. Here you can see direct and indirect and captured sandwich assays. So another last technique, which is competitive ELISA. Here we already discussed in the previous class radio immune assay. There is a competition between labeled and unlabeled antigen. The same principle here also we will use, but here radio labeled antigen is not used. Instead of that, we will use enzyme. Here, so competition occurs between the antigen which is present in the serum to be tested, which is unlabeled, and the antigen is conjugated with the enzyme which is labeled for the same antibody which is coated to the microtetravalents. Hence, there is a which is called as competitive ELISA. So after specific time of incubation, wells are washed. During washing, the unbound antigens are washed off with the buffer. Only bound antigen antibody complex are be present in the wells. Next, after the complex has been washed with the buffer, the enzyme substrate is added and the enzyme activity is measured by the spectrophotometrically. So the enzyme activity measured, which is proportional to the labeled antigen and inversely proportional to the unlabeled antigen in the sample. So come to the applications of ELISA. So this ELISA used for serological and quantitative determination in the laboratories and research labs, and it can be used in the biochemistry, serology, parasitology, and for several purposes requiring more sensitivity and specificity over the other methods. And it is a specific antigen antibody technique which specifically quantify analytes in milligrams to picograms. And hormones determined by the ELISA are, like example, T3, T4, TSH, LH, FSH, prolactin, and HCG, etc. and enzymes determined by ELISA are lipase and amylase, etc. And also it is also used for diagnosis of various microbiological samples, like for toxoplasma, rubella, herpes simplex virus and HIV, HPSS, tuberculosis. So there are long list of this analyte, and it is used for the identification of tetanus toxin and antibodies, meningitis, rotavirus and brucella, etc. And also it is used for identification of autoimmune diseases. Just write all the application and write at least 2 example for each. And advantages of ELISA: highly sensitive, up to the concentration of picogram levels of the antigen can be measured, and which is highly specificity, which is due to the antigen antibody specificity, and also which is a highly precision and accuracy, which is obtained by the ELISA processor. And this ELISA is suitable for even in a small laboratories also, and which is cheaper than the radioimmunoassay. And disadvantages of ELISA are, so this ELISA require specialized expert personnels, because in order to obtain the correct values and to reduce the wrong values, so we have to use a specialized expert personnel which is trained in the ELISA method, which is required. And also enzymes required cold environment for the storage. So these are the disadvantages of ELISA. Okay, so by this topic we complete the immunodiffusion techniques along with the immunoassays, which is asked in your syllabus. Okay, write it in your notes, and also read daily. Okay, thank you.